I'm not going to say that it's supernatural, because somewhere along the line we might find a natural explanation. That's the nature of the gaps. You said both in your opening statement and your rebuttal that people attribute to the supernatural when there is no other natural explanation available that they can think of. Mm-hmm. And I was trying to be clear that that is not at all what I was saying, that what we do, and I agree, a God of the gaps explanation is not acceptable to me, all right? But a nature of the gaps explanation is equally unacceptable to me, that when you look at it and you say, I don't know of any natural explanation. And yeah, a supernatural explanation would certainly work here, given that the laws of nature would suggest that's not possible. But I'm not going to say that it's supernatural, because somewhere along the line we might find a natural explanation. That's the nature of the gaps. And it's no better than a God of the gaps. So here's my question for you. I gave you that example of the beheading. I'm beheaded up here. Everybody's out of the auditorium. You've already seen my headless corpse. I come walking out an hour later, and you all see me alive, and I testify that I met someone in heaven, and they shared with me a private conversation that they had had with you that you know is correct. Now, wouldn't our understanding that that is impossible by natural causes, wouldn't that justify you to infer that a supernatural event has indeed occurred?
Yeah, so I like this question because it proposes the very thing that never happens. It goes to the extreme to say, if this happened, would you then accept that there's a supernatural explanation? And the short answer is no. What I would accept is that the null hypothesis that people's heads don't come back on, that's clearly disproved. The reason that you came back from the dead, the explanation for why and how this happened, I don't know. I'm not precluding the supernatural. There needs to be a demonstration that this is the cause. And frankly, in that situation, I'm not so sure that I care that much about why you were able to do that. Just that, you know, the possibility that something like that has happened would spur a new regime of investigation. I mean, where's the Nobel Prize for discovering the spiritual, the supernatural?
Okay, so I didn't ask whether that would convince you that God exists and raised me from the dead, okay? Or that my claim. But given all that data that you saw me beheaded, sure. Now I've come back, I'm alive, you see the scars, and I repeat that private conversation you had with that person, would that be enough to convince you that a supernatural event had occurred?
So here's where we get into a little bit of the word thing. I think by what you're asking, the answer is yes. But what I'm specifically addressing is that I don't get to call that supernatural. What it would be is there's something new and weird and undiscovered and unknown within nature. I would fully accept that it happened. If you're asking, would I then be reasonably convinced that the best explanation is that something beyond nature did this? I don't know.
You don't even know if that would convince you.
No. What does it mean to say that the supernatural caused something?
Something that is beyond, it's a cause, something either has a natural or supernatural cause. If our current understanding of nature and of natural law suggests that that is impossible, which it certainly does, then it seems to me one is justified in inferring that it's a supernatural cause. You can always, if some scientist discovers later on that, you know, nature can indeed do this, well, then you'd have to readjust your conclusion. But in the meantime, it's based on what we currently know from science and natural law that would seem to suggest that is impossible by natural causes, and so we would be right to infer a supernatural cause.
So what I just heard you say is that based on our current understanding, if we don't have a natural explanation, we are reasonable to infer a supernatural explanation.
It's not just having not a natural explanation. We know that such explanations are not even possible.
Based on our current understanding,
yes.
It's not possible. We're reasonable to infer a supernatural explanation. And then if at some later time a natural explanation arises, we should accept that.
Yes.
That is exactly how lightning got attributed to Thor.
Yeah, but we learned something. But it doesn't
okay,
stop us right
I
now,
don't
right?
care whether or not... So first of all, it's fallacious, because I care whether or not something is actually the explanation,
I
whether
do too.
Or not it's reasonable. So to say, hey, based on my current understanding, this is impossible given what we know about nature. Therefore, I'm going to call it supernatural. With the acknowledgement that later on somebody might find a natural explanation, my answer is you don't have justification to call it supernatural. What you're expressing there is a discomfort with saying, I don't know what the explanation
not
is.
Not at all. And just let me, one final thing. I would just say that if someone was beheaded like I'm given, and you were still unwilling to say supernatural, then, Matt, I think the problem is your epistemology there. I don't think there's anything practically that could convince you.